So here I am going to solve some questions based on percentage change. The first question is, the price of a car is lowered by 20% to ₹40,000. What was the original price? And also find a reduction in price. Two questions are there. First, you have to find out the original price, and second, you have to find out what is the reduction in price. Clear? And remember here, the price of a car is lowered by what? 20%. So here is the solution. Let the original price of the car is what? ₹100. And reduction is given 20% means what? ₹20. Clear? Because 100 into 20%. So this 100 and 100 cut. So what we have? 20. So here is the answer is what? 20. So reduced price will be what? 100 minus 20, that is 80. And if reduced price is 80, then the original price is what? 100. Like this we can solve by unitary method. And so if reduced price is 40,000, it is given 20% to 40,000. Then the original price will be what? Yes, 100 into 40,000 by 80. When you will solve, you will get ₹50,000. So reduction in price also you have to find out. So for that you will subtract 50,000 minus 40,000. So answer will be what? 10,000. Now the next question is, if the price of an article is increased by 25%, the increase is ₹10. Find a new price. So let the price of an article be what? 100. So increase is what? 25%. Mean increase will be what? 25. Again, like this you will find out. 100 into 25 by 100. So 100, 100 cancel. What you have? 25. If an increased price is 100 plus 25 means what? ₹125. So if increase is ₹25, then the new price is what? 25. And if increase is ₹10, then the new price will be what? 125 into 10 by 25. And so the answer is ₹50. Now next. The next question is, if the price of an article is reduced by 10% and the reduction is given here, what is the reduction? ₹40. What is the old price? Clear? So here is the process. Let the original price be what? 100. The reduction is 10%. 10% means what? 10. Clear? How 10? Same process. 10 into 100 by 100. 100, 100 cancel. Answer is 10. So if reduction is 10, then the old price is 100. If reduction is 40, then the old price will be what? 100 into 40 by 10. This is equal to 400. Now next, the price of a chair is reduced by 25%. What is the ratio of? First, you have to find change in price to the old price, and second, you have to find old price to the new price. So here is the solution. Let the original or the old price is what? 100. Reduction is 25% means what? 20. So reduced price will be what? 100 minus 25 is equal to 75. Okay. Now ratio between change in price and old price. So change in price is what? 25. Clear? Change in price is 25 and the original price is what? 100. So when you divide, you will get it by what? 1:4. Clear? 25 ones are 25 and 25 ones are 25 and 25 fours are 100. Now the next you have to find out ratio between the old price and the new price. The old price is what? 100 and new price is what? 75. So when you divide by 25, you will get 25 fours are 100 and 25 threes are 75. So answer will be what? 4:3. Next, the weight of a machine is 40 kg. By mistake, it was weighed as 40.8 kg. Find the error percent. Yes, error percent we have to find out. And you know, 40 it was. The weight of a machine was what? 40. And then by mistake, it weighed 40.8. It's very clear. Where is the, means what is the error here? 0.8 kg. Very easy. So actual weight 40. Errored weight is what? 40.8. So error in weight is what? 0.8 kg. So error percent will be what? 0.8 into 100 by 40. And when you will solve, you will get the answer 2%. Now next. From a cask containing 450 liters of petrol. 8% of the petrol was lost by leakage and evaporation. How many liters of petrol was left in the cask? So here is the solution. Original petrol in the cask 450 liters and leakage and evaporation 8%. So 8% of what? 8% of 450. So 8% of 450 will be equal to what? 36. Next is an alloy consists of 13 parts of copper, 7 parts of zinc and 5 parts of nickel. What is the percentage of each metal in the alloy? And here is the answer. So copper is 13, zinc is 7 and nickel is 5. Clear? So total alloy is what? 25 parts. Like this, when we'll add all, it will come 25 parts. Now we have to find out the percentage of each metal in the alloy. So each means what? First start with the copper. So copper 13. So 13 by total into 100. So 13 by total is what? 25. You will get 52%. Next is zinc. So zinc is what? 7. Here is 7. So 7 by 25 into 100. 28%. And the next is nickel. Nickel is what? 5 parts. So 5 by total. Total is what? 25. So 5 by 25 into 100. Answer is 20%. Now next, in an examination, first division marks are 60%. A student secures 538 marks and misses the first division by 2 marks. Find the total marks of the examination. Very good question. And you have a solution also here. So percentage for first division, 60%. And a student secures what? 538 marks, but misses the first division by 2 marks. So marks for first division will be what? 538 plus 2 means 540. Okay, so means 540 is what? Passing marks. But here it is given that the first division is what? 60%. Okay, so means we can say that the 60% of the total marks is equal to what? 540. Because here it is mentioned that a student secures 538 marks but misses the first division marks by 2%. Means for the first division, the marks should be what? 540. And in percentage, it is given 60%. So this 2 will be what? Equal. And so 60 by 100 of total marks. So total marks we can find. And the answer is what? 900. You know the calculation how to do? Yes, like 0, 0 cut here. Then 6, 9, and 9 into 100 is 900. Next question is, out of 1200 pupils in a school, 900 are boys and the rest are girls. If 20% of the boys and 30% of the girls wear spectacles, find how many pupils in all wear spectacles and what percent of the total number of pupils wear spectacles. Very good question. Of course it is lengthy, but the question is good. So number of boys 900 and number of girls, so 1200 minus 900, so total is what? 1200. So 1200 minus 900, so the answer is what? 300. Then the number of boys who wear spectacles, 20% of 900, so 20 by 100 into 900, this is equal to 180. And number of girls who wear spectacles, so 30% of 300, so 30 by 100 into 300, this is equal to 90. Clear? So the first one is what? The total number of people who wear what? Spectacles. Clear? It is wrong. Wrong typed here. It should be WEAR. So 180 plus 90, that is what? 270. And percentage in this you have to find out. Clear? You have to, this is the number. Here you have to find out the total number. And here you have to find out the percentage. Again, spelling mistake is here. So you will get what? 22.5%. So here, this 0 and this 0 you can cancel. So now you have 270 by 12. Now the next question is, out of 25 identical bulbs, 13 are red, 17 are red, 3 are black and the remaining are yellow. Find the difference between the numbers of red and yellow bulbs and express this difference as percentage. So here is the solution. So number of red bulbs, 17. Number of black, 3. Okay. So number of yellow bulbs will be what? 5. How? 25 minus 20. Total bulb was 25. And red and black is what? When you'll add, you will get what here? 20. So number of yellow bulb is what? 5. Difference between the number of red and yellow bulbs. So You will do subtraction, number of red, number of yellow, and the answer is what? 12. Now percentage difference is what? Difference in red and yellow bulbs by total into 100. So this is done here, and the answer is what? 48%. Okay, now next. A number first increases by 20% and then decreases by 20%. Find the percentage increase or decrease on whole. So here is the answer. Let the number be what? 100. So first condition is increase is what? 20% of 100. So 20% of 100 will be equal to what? 20. Number after this increase will become what? 120. 100 plus 20, 120. In second condition, decrease 20% of 120. Clear? So 20% of 120 is what? 24. Then number after this decrease is what? 120 minus 24, 96. And so total decrease on the whole will be what? 24 minus 20 is equal to 4. And so we have to find out the percentage decrease. So 4 by 100 into 100, this is equal to what? 4%. Now next, a number is first decreased by 40% and then again decreased by 60%. Find the percentage increase or decrease on the whole. So let the number be x. First condition, decrease 40% of 100, so 40 by 100, so 40. A number after this decrease, 100 minus 40 is equal to what? 60. Clear? Then in second condition, decrease is what? 60% of 40. So 60% of 40 we'll find out. A number after the second decrease, it will be what? 40 minus 24. Because this is the original, for this will be the original. Original minus 24, this will be 16. And so total decrease on the whole will be what? 40 plus 24, 64. And so again percentage decrease on the whole, this will be 64 by 100 into 100, this is equal to 64%. If 150% of a number is 750, find 60% of this number. This is very easy. Let the number be x, clear? I've done with x also, with 100 also, so that you all get familiar with both the pattern. So required number is x. So 150% of x is what? 750. So here we can find out the value of x, and value of x will be what? 500. Hence the required number is 500. Now 60% of 500 is equal to what? 300. This much is only. Okay. I hope all the questions and all the solutions have must have become clear to all of you. Thank you very much.